I received this question the other day and I thought it was interesting, so I figured it out. Is it possible to add conditions to a cell that determines what the save path is? For example, when you click save file, as in your video, if I wanted a condition that sets a different path based on the cell value. Well, I came up with some answers here. So what I've got here is I have a basic form and then I have the save button here at the bottom. Now, this is a drop-down list. If I choose one of those, it'll go to, I have three different folders here. The north is demo, south is demo 1, east is demo 2, west is demo 3. And so I'm going to send them to each of those. Now, if I have it blank and I go save, it will give me an error message saying, please select a sales area. And so I say, okay. And now, so now I select, for example, let's select south. Or how about east? And then I go save. And as you can see, the demo 2 file is open. It's got something in it now. Let me show you the code. So here's my code. Save or sub save file area. And then I go path as a string, file name as a string. And I go if range E4, and that's our value for where we're selecting the area. And I say if it's north, then go to a desktop, go to demo. If it's south, then go to demo 1. If it's east, then go to demo 2. And if it's west, go to demo 3. Else, and then you have the error message that comes up because there's no area in there. And then I have 4 if statements, and I have 4 end ifs at the end here. And then after the end ifs, I have file name equals range C4, and that's whatever. So it's the Fred Flintstone that we have here. And then it displays your false active workbook save as the path that you've selected there, plus the file name plus XLS and file format equals xlOpenXMLWorkbook. Now, what I've done here is I've turned back on the display alerts. Then I close the active workbook once it's saved, and then end sub. So I will, of course, include this code in my description of the video. Please subscribe.